लोग आ गए, एवरीबॉडी शुड कम। हेलो, सो स्टार्ट करें। अच्छा ठीक है, वो आएगा। ओके, सो वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। स्टार्ट कर रहा हूँ मैं। सो टुडे एक्चुअली यस्टरडे आई हैव जस्ट टॉक विद डॉक्टर। आवाज आ रही है?
यस सर, यस सर आ रही
है। सो यस्टरडे आई टॉक टू डॉक्टर, आई टॉक टू डॉक्टर संजीव। ही टोल्ड मी कि आई ऑलरेडी गिव द कोर्स lesson plan, okay, distribute all the teachers. So according to this lesson plan or course distribution, in my topic generally in this general pathology, okay, and I have covered in, I will try my best to cover all the topic regarding in this major exogenous and endogenous pigments, okay, metastatic and dystrophic calcification, photosensitization. Okay, no problem. And another is important is wound healing by primary and secondary intention, including growth factor. So these two topics just covered. And another is Dr. Sanjeev Kaushal and as well as in Deepak, they already taking classes of this disturbance in growth, disturbance in cell metabolism, cell injuries, inflammation. Chalo, theek, okay, no problem. Everything is okay. So I will decide to start my topic first to complete, and after that I will discuss another if I am free and take the classes of general pathology, because general pathology is very important. Without knowing the general pathology, you can't know the systemic pathology as well as in the special pathology. The special pathology, that means disease regarding the disease, like is bacterial disease, viral disease, any other disease. So today, slide share नहीं किया ना? So today, general pathology, disturbance of pigment metabolism, according to syllabus. So disturbance of pigment metabolism. First important, you read very carefully of this cell injuries, man. Okay, cell injury is very important. Like in postgraduate study, I've covered this general pathology because उनको भी पढ़ना है on BSc student को general pathology. So that's why my focus aim to first complete the general pathology. After that, we will discuss later on in this systemic as well as another important of this avian pathology. Avian pathology or as well as in the spatial pathology, these are completely based on the practical basis. Okay, theoretically as well as practical. So today my class here, my topic is disturbance of pigment metabolism. या अगर इसको आप फर्स्ट लाइन में जान सकते हो तो द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट ऑफ दिस वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट पैथोलॉजिकल पिगमेंटेशन एंड पिगमेंट्स पैथोलॉजिकल पिगमेंटेशन. इन दिस पैथोलॉजिकल पिगमेंटेशन ये मैं हम लोग डिटेल्स इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग इन दिस पिगमेंटेशन वो मैं करते रहूँगा यार, मैं बहुत डिस्टर्ब होता हूँ यार, एक टाइम में आ जाओ, अदरवाइज फॉरगेट इन द क्लासेस, एवरी टाइम जस्ट एडमिट. सो because I have given already 15 minutes, man. This is a long time. Just I have completed my work of this under postgraduate work. And next week, just a class start of the examination of postgraduate studies. I have prepared the class routine. Yeah, examination routine. Before that, just enter in the class. Already 20 minutes. फिर भी लोग आते रहते हैं, so ये बड़ा disturb होता है इसमें. Mind it, इसमें थोड़ा focus करो. So pathological pigmentation and pigments. Okay. Pathological pigmentation and pigments. So, in this, before we start of this pathological pigmentation or disturbance of pigment metabolism, you know, pigmentation of certain cells in the body could be physiological as the pigments in the skin, as well as hair. And fingers, right? So pigmentation could be pathological when it is component of animal diseases, right? So the body pigments are divided into two parts. Number one is exogenous pigments, and another one is endogenous. So before we start, मैं चाहता हूँ पहले तुम लोग इसको समझो. ये PPT as well as the book is okay, वो पढ़ते रहना PPT. But because pigmentation of certain cell in the body could be physiological. फिजियोलॉजी ओके एज द पिगमेंट इन द स्किन एज वेल एज हेयर और फिगर्स पिगमेंटेशन कुड बी पैथोलॉजिकल कब होगा वेन इट इज कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द एनिमल डिजीजेस तभी तो उसको पैथोलॉजिकली मैं मानूंगा राइट एनिमल डिजीजेस द बॉडी पिगमेंट्स आर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स नंबर वन इज एक्सोजेनस पिगमेंट्स एवरीबॉडी नो एक्सोजेनस एंडोजेनस एंड अनदर वन इज एंडोजेनस पिगमेंट व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंट ऑफ दिस एक्सोजेनस पिगमेंट्स The exogenous pigment which are formed outside the body, clear, right? And endogenous pigment, okay, which are formed where inside the body, right? So इसीलिए इसको divide किया गया because this is the classification divided into two parts. Number one is exogenous pigments and another one is endogenous pigments. So now next I will discuss about in this exogenous pigment. क्या आप इसके बारे में जानते हैं सो क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सोजेनस पिगमेंट्स एंड टर्मिनोलॉजीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ओके यू डोंट नो द टर्मिनोलॉजीज ऑफ एंथ्राकोसिस सेलिकोसिस कोल डस्ट ओके द एनिमल इज ग्रेजिंग इन द आउटसाइड द फील्ड वेयर द एरिया इज जस्ट इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया स्मोकिंग एरिया ऑलवेज जस्ट ग्रेजिंग इन द आउटसाइड द फील्ड कोल डस्ट आएगा लंग्स आर अफेक्टेड इन द एंथ्राकोसिस डिसिपेनिया हो रहा है डिफिकल्टी इन ब्रीथिंग एज वेल एज इन द एस्पेक्सिया आल्सो यू कैन सी यू हैव कंडक्ट द पोस्टमार्टम एग्जामिनेशन तो ये पैथोलॉजिकल चेंजेस है तो पैथोलॉजिकल चेंजेस कब हम देखेंगे बिकॉज पिगमेंटेशन वुड बी पैथोलॉजिकल व्हेन इट इज कंपोनेंट ऑफ द एनिमल डिजीज तो आ रहा है तभी तो इसको पैथोलॉजी में मुझे बताना है अदरवाइज ये क्या है पिगमेंटेशन है फिजियोलॉजिकली भी आप जानते हैं फिजियोलॉजिकल फंक्शन में आप पिगमेंटेशन होते हैं सो exogenous and as well as endogenous pigments exogenous outside the body as well as endogenous inside the body clear so in this exogenous pigmentation classification of exogenous this is my notes man I'm not giving up the PPT. ये मेरा अपना सोच है. I don't know you may say कितने लोग इससे इत्तेफाक रखते हैं. But this is my own. ये notes जो है मैं इसको एक PPT के शक्ल में तुम्हें दिखा रहा हूँ. ये Google और ये वो ठीक है. वो सब रहता है अपने जगह पे. I have shown your histopathological slide as well as the gross slide. But this is the notes. मैं चाहता हूँ कि first you read very carefully. मैं जानता हूँ कितने लोग कितने बुक से पढ़ते हैं कितने नहीं पढ़ते हैं. और उनको नोट्स का बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंस रहता है. तो ये बहुत पुरानी 2009-10 के आसपास का नोट्स है. उसको मैंने एक शक्ल दिया ताकि आप उसको पढ़ सकें. एंड देन वी विल डिस्कस. सो दिस इज द टर्मिनोलॉजिकल बिफोर द टर्मिनोलॉजी क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सोजेनस पिगमेंटेशन एंड टर्मिनोलॉजी के बारे में क्या जानते हैं. एबनॉर्मल डिपोजिशन ऑफ कलर्ड सब्सटेंसेस ऑफ डाइवर्स ऑरिजिन. ठीक है. ये रनल्स का बुक एज वेल एज कॉलिक्स बुक से हमको कुछ जो मैं पढ़ता था उसी का ये पार्ट वाइज है. उसका पॉइंट्स है जो नोट्स की शक्ल में मैंने बनाया था. सो एबनॉर्मल डिपोजिशन ऑफ कलर्ड सब्सटेंसेस ऑफ द डाइवर्स ऑरिजिन इन द सेल और टिश्यू इज कॉल्ड पैथोलॉजिकल पिगमेंटेशन. मैं बताया हूं तुम्हें. इसी को मैंने इसमें लिख कर देखा हूं. ओके. सो द पिगमेंट्स मे बी फॉर्म्ड विद इन द बॉडी इन व्हिच दे आर कॉल्ड एज एंडोजेनस. अगेन आई विल अकॉर्डिंग योर स्लाइड दिखाना भी जरूरी है. Of the pigments come from the outside of the body such as the mineral, medicine, plants, etc. They are called as exogenous pigments. Okay. So exogenous pigments क्या क्या होंगे, क्या क्या importance है उसके और क्या आप देखते हैं. This is the some points just we have discussed. ये आप देख लो notes के शक्ल में अदर उसको इसमें देख लो. So number one is we have read about this pneumoconiosis. Okay, pneumoconiosis is dust of various kinds, coal dust, whatever, iron dust, stone dust, asbestos dust may be inhaled by the animals. These dust, besides the imparting the color, cause fibrosis of the lungs. First time, this condition is known as pneumoconiosis. General terms like that. Pneumonia, jante ho. After completion of this general pathology, then you will start. You will start in this systemic pathology. इन सिस्टमिक सिस्टमिक वाइज में आ जाता है कार्डियोवास्कुलर सिस्टम, रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम, ओके, हीमोबायोटिक सिस्टम, यूरिनरी सिस्टम, लाइक दैट. सो इन दिस बताओ यार इस वक्त आने का कोई टाइम नहीं है. सो डस्ट ऑफ वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ कोल्ड डस्ट, आयरन डस्ट, स्टोन डस्ट, जो भी कह सकते जो डस्ट आते हैं इनहेल कर पाए. ओके. There are causes of this fibrosis of the lungs. Fibrosis karega lungs mein. So this condition is called as pneumoconiosis. Simple term. Okay. So another is important points. There are some terminologies jo main batana ja raha hu. That is anthracosis. Very commonly we have seen in the postmortem examination of the buffalo as well in the cow, in the large animal. You can see something like anthracosis. So, okay. So anthracosis is a condition in which carbon particles formed as a black pigment in the tissue. Okay, carbon particles. ये छोड़ दो, ये तुम पढ़ना अपना देखना, ये मैं बता रहा हूँ. So anthracosis is the condition in which particles, carbon particles are formed as a black pigments in the tissue. ये black pigments हो गया, carbon है, black ही हो जाता है. So carbon particles occurs in the lungs and lymph node. Okay, where it is important of this lymph node, periscopular lymph node. Right, ये मैं एक टर्म बता रहा हूँ. Lymph node clear है, आप इतना भी लिख दोगे that is sufficient. Lymph node. Okay, draining the lungs of an animals and men who work in the coal mines areas or live in the smoky sites. So these particles appears as minute black granules in the alveolar wall. Lungs se related hai to alveolar wall ko affected kar raha hai. So alveolar walls and in the connective tissue etc. Okay, so they are cytoplasm in the lymph. Okay, they are in the either between the cells or have been phagocytized by the macrophages into the cytoplasm. Okay, so agar ye baat lungs ki ho, alveolar wall affected kar raha hai, ठीक है ना, अल्वियोलर वॉल अफेक्टेड करेगा, फैगोसाइटोसिस होगा, फैगोसाइटोसिस होगा, जो माइक्रोफेजेस वाई माइक्रोफेजेस इनटू देयर साइटोप्लाज्म होने में ये तुमको सिखाई देगा लाइक शुक्राणु. बट व्हाट अबाउट द लिम्फ नोड्स? सो इन द लिम्फ नोड्स दे अपीयर बिटवीन द लिम्फोइड सेल्स. क्लियर? लिम्फोइड सेल्स, दिस इज कॉज्ड बाय इनहेलेशन ऑफ कोल डस्ट और कार्बन पार्टिकल्स इन ए स्मोकिंग एरिया. दे डू नॉट कॉज एनी डैमेज बट ये इनहेल हो सकता. When the animal every time moving in the outside the field and grazing in the field and up, every time the anthracosis cold dust or carbon dioxide aate rahe, but difficulty in breathing hoga, that is dyspnea hoga, difficulty in breathing ho raha hai. But it is also the causes of the disease, animal disease. So pathologically hum log pigmentation mein isko dekh rahe hain. If the animal is died something and we have see the postmortem lesions, first you see the tracheal lumen, open the cat of the tracheal lumen, you see this some carbon particles, blackish color of the particles are present, must are present in the tracheal lumen. Okay, pata nahi tumne postmortem kiya ki nahi, I don't know. And after jab tak bhai respiratory system affected kar raha hai, first you see the trachea, then lungs. So alveolar septum jo hai affected kar raha hai, ya alveolar wall jo hai wahan pe carbon particles mil raha hai, wo to baat ki cheez hai, that is another thing. But first you should see the tracheal lumen. There is some carbon particles are present in this area, and after that we also conduct the postmortem. Especially respiratory system are more affected in this condition. Okay, ये तो बात हो गई. So मैं तो बता भी दिया हूँ उसको. और जब speed चलते हैं तो जल्दी हो जाएगा, because समझाने में बड़ा time भी लगता है. So basically we have seen the postmortem results. Lung shows the black streak or spots, especially at the lower borders of the area. Lungs have the prepared appearance. Okay. Maybe देखना अगर कोई said some mistake of this writing, because I have given the notes to my staff to change of this transfer to this PPT. ये मैंने slide निकाल के दिया उसको आज. So it just prepared in this PPT because I'm not in support certain time. So the notes को उसने PPT का शक्ल में बनाया. So you see any spelling mistake or something, you should clear it. The medulla of the lymph nodes is darker in the color. The carbon particles only in the mild irritants and so large scale of fibrosis center is simple term hai, but we have seen the alveolar wall hota hai, alveolar wall mein changes dikhega. Okay, the carbon particles appear is a minute black granules in the alveolar wall and in the connective tissue septa. Okay, so they may be either between the cells or have been phagocytized by macrophages into their cytoplasm. Why it is important? So this is caused by inhalation of coal dust or carbon particles in the smoking area. The smoking areas, they are do not cause any damage of this area. But every time this smoke or inhaled by the animals outside the field, they have caused the respiratory problem. Okay, man. So this is the microscope. Before that, microscopical, that means gross lesions microscopy. Whatever you write, it is okay. This is microscopical or histopathological, whatever you say. Nowadays, in book की शक्ल में जो आते हैं, in book में we have read in this micro and micro. But you can write in the postmortem lesions, gross lesions, yeah, postmortem lesions as well as in the histopathological. Micro means you have seen the microscopic, na? So that means the microscopic. So in microscopically or histopathologically, the pigment is seen as a black granules either between the cell or within the phagocytes. जो मैंने पहले बताया. In the lungs, it is present in the alveolar wall or connective tissue septa. अब इसकी sequel की मैं बात करूँ. Usually no serious damage occurs. I told you earlier, man. But in heavy deposition, especially when combined with silicon dioxide, fibrosis of lungs is very common, take place as seen in the mice, right? And we have conducted postmortem. I've conducted postmortem examination of the small animal like goat in this areas of some Muzaffarpur side, because RUP time wahan pe tha, and I've seen these cases of this coal dust, heavy particles are present, carbon particles are present in. Now another important topic, this is the silicosis. Okay, silicosis. So in this silicosis, this is the presence of silicon dioxide dust in pulmonary tissues, right? Silicon dioxide is inhaled in the rock mines, jahan patthar wagera tode jaate hain. The affected pulmonary tissue is nodular and fern-like structure. The silicon dioxide occurs in the tissue as fine crystals. Iski baat chhod de raha hu bhaiya, tum apna padhte rehna. Fine crystals. Okay. The crystals cause the proliferation of the connective tissue. Proliferate karega. So the crystals cause the proliferation of the connective tissue, which takes the form of dense sclerotic nodules. ठीक है, सो बेसिकली क्या समझ में आया? दो तीन इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट नजर आए. नंबर वन इज इंपॉर्टेंट, देयर इज द स्टोन या रॉकिंग एरिया जहां पे होता है, द एनिमल जहां पे मूव करते हैं, प्लेसेस में या ओके, उस एरिया में इन सिलिकोसिस प्रेजेंस इज सिलिकॉन डाइऑक्साइड. इन दिस सिलिकॉन डाइऑक्साइड डस्ट जो उसके होते हैं आर अफेक्टेड इन द पल्मोनरी टिश्यू. ये बात क्लियर हो गई? इतना लिख दोगे उसको तुम इलैबोरेट कर देना, दिस इज योर पॉइंट एंड यू हैव इलैबोरेट ऑल ऑफ इट. बट अब तो ऑनलाइन का जमाना है तो कुछ कहना मुश्किल. सो सिलिकॉन डाइऑक्साइड इज इनहेल इन द रॉक माइंस, जो मैंने बता दिया. द अफेक्टेड पल्मोनरी टिश्यू इज नोड्यूलर एंड फर्न लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. नोड्यूल्स का फॉर्मेशन होता है, नोड्यूल्स लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. नाउ एज़ फार एज़ पैथोजेनेसिस इज कंसर्न्ड, द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ सिलिकेट्स इंटर द एल्वियोलाई, देयर दे आर इंगल्फ्ड बाय माइक्रोफेजेस. माइक्रोफेजेस का काम ही यही रहता है, विच ट्रांसपोर्ट देम टू द intrapulmonary lymphatics and they to the lymph nodes. yahi to aayega. The silicates are converted into salicylic acid, which is highly toxic to the tissue due to irritation, fibrosis, etc. ye to convert karega long term agar dekh rahe ho to. The silicates as silicate dioxide jo hota hai, silicates are converted into this salicylic acid. This salicylic acid are more toxic when inhaled in the body, particularly in these animals. So in this condition tissue kya hoga, irritation hoga, fibrosis hoga of the lungs. Okay, as well as we also can see some changes of the liver also. Fibrosis ho jata liver mein bhi changes aa sakte. So as far as postmortem lesions is concerned, when the animal is died, something like that. Okay, so in this position, postmortem lesions is concerned, just a minute. So gross lesions is concerned, in this position the pleura is thick and numerous circular nodules of various size are seen through all the lungs. Nodular forms like structure chote granule type shape mein aata hai through all the lungs parenchyma. Local emphysema and bronchiectasis may be noticed. Spilling dekh lena, theek hai, may be noticed. So So histopathologically is concerned. So in this, the silicotic nodules has a characteristic appearance around the central particles of the silica, form concentric lamina of the hyaline collagen. You already read in hydrotic degeneration or hyaline degeneration. Have you read? So in this hyaline degeneration, you see the silicotic nodules has a characteristic appearance around central particles of silica are formed in concentric lamina of hyaline collagen. Number 1 point. Number 2 is important is pulmonary arteries are thickened in this condition. Local areas of infrasymmetrical lungs here, lymphysema and bronchiectasis are seen. Vitalization of alveolar epithelium may also be noticed in this portion. So emphysema of lungs are very common in BFC. Now another is important is plumbism. Okay. So in this plumbism is also important of this pigmentation, exogenous pigmentation. This is effect pigmentation, plumbism is pigmentation of tissue resulting from the presence of both lead and hydrogen sulfide. So it occurs when lead is ingested in the form of paint or when water or food containing lead is consumed. Those areas where the animals are, where the areas are affected in this lead toxicity, okay, fluoride toxicity, in this condition, plumbism condition. So grossly, we have seen the pigmentation only those areas where hydrogen sulfide is present. Hydrogen gas ka bahut nikalna hai karta hai. The lead in the tissue combines with hydrogen sulfide. Agar milta hai to form lead sulfide. Okay. To form lead sulfide. This lead sulfide is a black pigmentation. Black pigmentation. So, thus the pigmentation generally we have seen in the gum area, your gum lines, where lead in the tissue comes in contact with the hydrogen sulfide. Okay. Or jab is condition mein aega, so there is some putrefactic bacteria also in there. So, putrefaction always happens. So, putrefaction, your putrefactive bacteria found in the teeth. So that's why heavy salivation occurs. Putrefaction hoga. There is some tacky smell generally we have in the animals. Here the animals is moving graze like in the area of this lead toxicity, fluoride toxicity. You have seen very clearly. So similarly, the intestinal mucosa may be gray colored. Focus may be gray due to the presence of lead sulfides. A very important point, sir. Objectively push that so you can. Now argyrosis is also important. Main simple terminology ka term se bhi main tumhe bata raha hu, notice kijiye. So argyrosis is also the condition, there is notice the long continued therapy of silver salt. So in microscopically or gross lesion is concerned, there is some skin or conjunctive become gray or gray blue in color due to internal eyes. Internal organs may show similar pigmentation. जो आपने पहले देखा लीड टॉक्सिसिटी में. Now as histopathological examination is concerned, the pigment is not intracellular, but it is deposited in these cement substances. Okay, because in the skin it is found in the dermis just under the epidermis layer. But in case of the internal organs are affected, where while in the kidney it is deposited in the lamina of the glomeruli and outside the tubular epithelium of the black granular deposits. Kidney ki baat kar raha hu, because in the kidneys it is deposited in the lamina of the glomeruli and outside the tubular epithelium of the black granular deposits. But in case in the liver, there we are seeing the Kupffer cells arterioles are in the venules of liver. So jahan tak visible ki baat hai, no harm appears to the cause except the this pigmentation of the face of man is gray or ash color, and this is the permanent blemish regularly we have seen. Human being also affected. Dekhna thoda jaldi chalna hai, time ka bada dikkat hoti. So ye exogenous ki hai. Now there is some medicines also we have given in the animals. So because some important medicine generally we use in this tetracycline. So in this tetracycline gets deposited in the bone if it is used for prolonged treatment. लंबे टाइम तक अगर उसको करते हैं, लंबे वक्त तक करते हैं, the drugs give yellowish discoloration of the bones, which is gives yellowish greenish autofluorescence under fluorescence microscopy of section of the bones. ये तुम्हें postmortem results में show नहीं दिखाई देगा. Okay, under fluorescence microscopy we have seen the yellowish greenish color show करेगा. Prolonged use of treatment, yeah, prolonged treatment of this tetracycline. Now tattooing, in first year already you have read in the, or practical you have seen in the LPM department tattoo. So in tattooing the pigments particles are transported by the macrophages to the connective tissue. Okay, so this pigment is not found in the epidermis cells. The phagocytes may also be transported and deposited in the pigments in the regional lymph nodes area. So basically the pharyngeal lymph nodes, periscapular lymph nodes, these lymph nodes are basically affected in this tattooing condition. Same another is important is this carotenoid pigments, pearl and eye some chote chote terms hai, and I think you already read in this one very clearly. So thoda speed hona chahiye because it's a completely okay and not up to time this thing because easy course work is काफी ज्यादा है. Anyway, so man, this is the endogenous pigments. Exogenous pigments की जहां तक बात है, so ये है. Now endogenous pigments में important है, to endogenous pigments है internal of the body, so that's why the important of this melanin. सब लोग जानते हैं. Melanin is a brown black pigment formed in the melanocytes. Tyrosine melanin protect the skin against harmful rays in the ray. Human being हम लोग भी देखते हैं sunlight में है. बाइक चला रहे हो या कुछ समथिंग पर्टिकुलरली द फेस एरिया और पर्टिकुलरली दिस पोर्शन वी हैव सीन ज्यादा कलर का चेंजेस होता है इफेक्ट ऑफ दिस इन द अदर बॉडी होता है. सो मेलानिन माइक्रोस्कोपिकली मेलानिन अपीयर्स अ वेरी माइन्यूट यूनिफॉर्मली रेगुलर डर्टी ब्राउन इन कलर स्फेरिकल ग्रैनुल्स लाइक स्ट्रक्चर बट इन केस द पैथोलॉजिकल अमाउंट्स ऑफ द पैथोलॉजी पैथोलॉजिकली वी हैव सीन द मेलानिन पैथोलॉजिकल अमाउंट्स ऑफ द मेलानिन इज कॉल्ड एज मेलानोसिस. And it is frequently observed in the associated with क्या क्या चीज में इसका associated हो रहा है वो देख लेना. Important points है the tumor melanoma because it is affected in the way horses and heavily pigmented in the breeds of the dog. Addison disease, there is some bilateral destruction of the adrenal due to क्या very common है tuberculosis, atrophy or neoplasm of the cases. Now melanocosis coli, which is a condition in which the rectums and collar contain melanin in their mucosa, giving them brownish color. And ये बताया ही जाता है acanthosis nigrans, ठीक है? Dog suffering from Sertoli cells. Tumors के तुम लोग पढ़ोगे या पढ़ रहे हो आज दोनों, अभी तो start है. In which there is the estrogen production, raised rough black color. So मेरा notes है इसीलिए मैं इसको पढ़ के बता रहा हूँ. Definitely. और ये सब पढ़ लेना. ये मैं इसको अलग अलग कर दिया हूँ. द कंडीशन विच डिफिशियंट प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द मेलानिन एल्बिनिज्म क्या है लिपोडर्मा विटिलिगो लिपोफिशियंस. ओके थैंक्स. आई एम डिस्क्राइब बिकॉज ये मेरा क्वेश्चन जब मैं पूछता हूँ एंड आस्क द क्वेश्चन पर्टिकुलर इन द एग्जामिनेशन ग्रॉस लेजर माइक्रोस्कोपिकल एग्जामिनेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो दैट्स व्हाई इसी हिसाब से मैंने इसको. Now, as far as derivatives of hemoglobin is concerned, how much time you are completing? As far as derivatives of hemoglobin is concerned, ठीक है. Derivatives of hemoglobin, ये तो तुम पढ़ लेना. The pigments derived from hemoglobin are hemosiderin number one and bilirubin. दो चीज़ याद रखना. हीमोग्लोबिन डेरिवेटिव्स में अगर मुझे बताना है तो ड्राइव फ्रॉम द हीमोग्लोबिन आर हीमोसिड्रिन हेपेटिन हीमेटिन एंड बिलिरुबिन. तीन हुआ हीमोसिड्रिन हेमेटिन एज वेल एज इन द बिलिरुबिन. हीमोसिड्रिन पिगमेंट्स इज ब्राउन कंटेंस एंड यूजुअली present in the macrophages of reticuloendothelial system, RE system. Okay. When the erythrocytes have served their purpose, they are destroyed by the reticuloendothelial system of the spleen. Okay. And as well as liver and bone marrow, and they split in the hemoglobin into two pigments. Concon, the iron containing hemosiderin and the iron free bilirubin. Yeah, bilirubin pigments, the complex globin. No points. Okay. So the iron containing hemosiderins and दो चीज में अगर इसको डिवाइड करते हैं, नंबर वन इज इम्पोर्टेंट इज हिमोसिड्रिन, आयरन कंटेनिंग हिमोसिड्रिन, एंड अनदर इज आयरन फ्री बिलिरुबिन. सो इन दिस केस हिमोग्लोबिन का क्या इंपॉर्टेंस है, हिमोसिड्रिन का क्या इंपॉर्टेंस है, हिमैटिन का क्या इंपॉर्टेंस है, दीज आर द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट जस्ट वी हैव गिवन द discuss about of this one. This is the importance of this porphyria, yeah, porphyrin, this one. Isko padhe padhna ji, padhna to uske baad mujhe phir I will ask you something regarding next classes. So porphyria or porphyrins, yeah, porphyrins pigments are related to hemoglobin. Accumulation of porphyrin has been described in the cattle, basically we are focused in the cattle, swine and cat, as a metabolic defects in the synthesis of normal heme pigments. So in this case, ferroportophyrin, due to enzyme deficiency which results in overproduction of porphyrin, which accumulate in the tissue. वही तो होगा. In case in cattle, the disease is inherited is a simple Mendelian recessive, whereas in the swine, genetically inheritance है. Mendelian recessive genes के बारे में बता. Whereas in the swine and cat, it's inherited in the dominant characteristics. The dominant situation of dermatitis when exposed to strong sunlight. So in this case, the accumulation of porphyrin is dentine, the dentin, dentine and bone give rise to red color, which is referred to as pink tooth. So affected teeth. Okay. So in these affected teeth and bones, you see a strong grayish fluorescence with ultraviolet rays and is useful for the diagnosis of this one. So fluorescence microscopically we have to see very clearly of this porphyrin cases. Now we see porphyrin cases. So I told you earlier, so hematidine, first hematidine देख लेना, then porphyrin. ये अगर बताता हूँ, मैंने दे दिया just PPT उसने बना दिया मेरे notes से. So hematidine is the place where the hemorrhages occurs. Hematidine may be deposited in these pigments. The color of the bluish or condition. So hematidine first converted into bilirubin, as we know, and so the bluish in the greenish color. Subsequently, the color changes to the yellow. Bilirubin is converted into bilirubin. It is extracellular outside the body of the cell. जो होता है हम लोग देखते हैं. और जहाँ तक बात है bilirubin का, everybody you know very clearly. So it is derived from the hemoglobin but contains no iron. Okay, so it is the major pigments of the blue when bilirubin is invaded into blood and deposits in the tissue, and it is resulting in common clinical disorder due to jaundice. Similarly, dekhte hain hum log bilirubin ka kitna bada hai. So